Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to set a keyboard shortcut for a character or paragraph style in Adobe InDesign. Now, I do want to mention that if you don't have a number pad on your keyboard, this will not work for you. So it'll need to look like this, the long keyboard with the numbers on the right side, or this little pad that you can buy separately. So if you don't have one of those two options, this tutorial will not work for you. All right, let's get started. All right, so I'm here in InDesign, and this is the document I'm working on. This has a character style already set up. It is this bold yellow right here, and we can see it over here in character styles. It's named bold. Now, if we double click our character style, you want to come over here and double click it here, because otherwise you'll get a rename box. So I'm going to come over here, double click, and get my options open. Now here under general, we can see we have the option for a shortcut. So I'll click in there and I'll hold command, and then on my number pad, I'll hit the number 2. So now we have command plus number 2. We'll say okay. Now we can highlight the next part of the text that we want to apply this character style to. And then with our number pad, we can hit command 2 and it'll apply to the highlighted section. And that's it. Now, as far as I know, the only shortcuts that don't allow you to use the top numbers on your keyboard are the paragraph and character style keyboard shortcuts. So if you come up here to edit keyboard shortcuts right here, you can use any of the numbers. They don't have to be on the 10 key number pad here. So if you don't have a 10 key number pad, you'll just have to pin your paragraph and character styles over here. And you can do that by coming up here to Window, Styles, and Paragraph Styles. It'll probably put it out here like this, but you can pin it by just dragging it here until you get like a blue bar and dropping it. And now it'll always be here. You can put them in the same one by just dragging like this. And then if you want to save your workspace, you can go to Window, Workspace, and choose New Workspace, name it anything you want, and then you can always reset and have these pinned in this location for easy access. All right, I hope this video was helpful. If you liked it and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.